We're going to look inside some celebrity houses now, the ones making headlines all over the world. Our travel commentator and a great friend of the show, Nicolina Carufa, joins us now to take us through them. Hello, Nicolina.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Very good.
Bright and blue this morning.
Yes.
Thank you.
Looking good. Let's talk about celebrity homes because there's a couple that have made some great headlines this week, starting with Ellen DeGeneres. Gosh, she's dabbled in some serious property.
She's a mogul, isn't she?
Maddie will be devastated that she's missing an Ellen DeGeneres flip because she's crazy for Ellen Holmes.
Oh no, I've stolen it from her. She bought and sold 7 properties last year. Mm. This is her first acquisition for 2019.
So she's obviously not worried about the stamp duty over there in California.
Nope.
No.
Not at
she
all.
She sells them. She's not just buying them to hold them.
That's right. Buying and selling. She's keeping it going. This particular one is a Montecito mansion, Balinese style home. It's very impressive inside and out.
We've had this on their show before. Yeah. Haven't we, when it was on the market?
Well,
and of course it's Ellen that bought it.
Yeah, it's a very unique home.
Snapped it up for $38 million. Now, she did sell a Tuscan-style estate in Montecito last year for $34 million, so kind of funded this particular purchase.
Wow.
It sits on 8.2 acres of land, including an additional vacant parcel, which she can do what she likes with. I don't know what else you put on this property, though. It's 5-bedroom, 10-bath. Bathroom, has a cabana that doubles up as a gym, a beautiful basalt pebble infinity pool outside that overlooks the Pacific Ocean. The outside is just as impressive as the inside, as you can see. It is beautiful, expansive lawn, garden, skyline views of the Pacific Ocean and some exotic tropical plants to really take that Balinese style from inside to
out. Almost an executive play on the Balinese feel, isn't it? It almost feels like a higher end resort or hotel.
Kind of a contemporary Asian feel of
the
home.
Fusion. Yeah, fusion.
So inside you've got, it's very wondrously private, which is what Ellen really likes with her properties. The house is tucked behind a long-winded driveway, invisible from the street from out front. But then as you head inside the property, you've actually got these beautiful disappearing walls of glass on the southern side to allow that easy access to the veranda outside, the alfresco dining area. There's also a guest house, because you always need a guest house.
Yes.
Has 2 ensuite bedrooms and a kitchen and a detached office as well. It's just
Sophie
stunning.
Sophie puts me in her guest house all the time. I really love that pool at the rear. It almost looks like a big designer, those container pools, that style, the way that it sits out. It really projects out into the view. It's quite a beautiful
And
beautiful
with
location.
That extra parcel of land, they do have a menagerie of pets, don't they?
Yeah.
So maybe that's
they
where they can keep them.
They
little
do.
Doggy walk park.
Very impressive. Now, it's actually directly across the street as well from another property that she owns, a far more modest equestrian ranch that she purchased last year for $9.4 million.
Right.
She really does like this
that's
area.
Where you put the menagerie.
She's not
I
straight.
I put in the suburb.
I wonder how long she'll stay. She seems very flighty, though, doesn't she?
She's so busy that she gets a bit mixed up and confused, pulls into the driveway.
Yeah.
Instead of being embarrassed I'm in the wrong house, I'll just buy it.
Yeah.
Just get it.
Quick.
Just
actually,
get
I want this anyway.
Yeah, Porsche.
Get the checkbook.
Yeah, grab the Porsche and the house.
Porsche's her wife.
Yes, I know.
Oh, right.
I was playing a pun. I know.
Okay.
She's Australian. I know exactly who she is.
All right, let's move to Jennifer Garner now. Now, we heard last year her and Ben Affleck, her ex-husband, sold their massive multiple-acre family compound over in Pacific Palisades. They sold it for $49.2 million. Ooh. Now she's set up a temporary house in a rented mansion.
Temporary.
Yeah. So this is actually owned by Dean Factor, who's the great-grandson of Max Factor, the popular makeup company. He has his own. It's called Smashbox Cosmetics and an expansive portfolio of real estate. Him and his wife purchased this property 10 years ago for $13.3 million, worth much
beautiful contrast. Look at how white it is with those rich, dark floors. I love dark floors so much. People are scared of them sometimes, Nicolina, but I love them.
Dark hardwood floors
is
a big, big characteristic of this place. It's grandly proportioned living and entertaining spaces. Have those dark wooden floors inside. It's behind a high hedge at the head of a horseshoe driveway. 6 bedrooms, 6 full and 2 half bathrooms in this place over 3 floors. It does have a master suite featuring a vaulted ceiling, very impressive, marble-faced fireplace, fitted walk-in closet and dressing room, white marble bathrooms. So I really love that contrast of you've got that darkness
what
on the
entry.
Floor and then that white lighting up all of the ceilings.
It's a really crisp white, and all the wooden panelling and the detailing. It's got It's a very stunning home.
I hope she doesn't have a dog with white fur. Somebody would be like walking around sweeping up after it.
Yeah.
She'd have someone there.
And three children, like dirty mitts
doing
on those,
painting.
All that white. Yeah.
Oh, that'd be
colourful.
Don't
let them help you bake the brownies, Jennifer.
A lot of shoes there, Sophie. That can fit all your shoes in there.
Walk-in wardrobe, of course. She needs one. She's going to have a lot of shoes to fit in there. And one thing I would say about this place, it's very a lot of leisure options as well. It has a climate-controlled wine cellar, gym with a sauna, a professional movie theatre with tiered seating as well.
Mm-hmm. I like even with the wine cellar as a leisure option off the top.
Oh, like, there's no argument there that a wine cellar is a leisure option. You can
come over and hang out in the wine cellar.
We think it's a day-to-day feature. Do we know the price?
Unknown amount, but she is staying here while she waits construction of her own Brentwood fixer-upper that she's working on that she bought for $11 million.
Right. So, I mean, for this level of home, we've had similar properties on the show before and they pay ridiculous figures.
$40,000 a month.
Yes.
Just sitting
it's
there
crazy.
In the savings account.
But, I mean, it's all relative, isn't it, for the cost of the property and the location. So, beautiful place.
Yeah. Got one more for you today.
Yes.
Armie and Elizabeth Hammer. They're a celebrity couple. Armie, you would know from the very popular film that came out last year, On the Basis of Sex, with Kylie Minogue was in that as well. He's slid himself into a Hancock Park traditional home.
Isn't he?
Yeah. Very, very good looking. Look at those bright blue eyes.
He is handsome.
Okay, this is about homes, guys. So it's a very dignified residence in Los Angeles' historic Hancock Park neighbourhood. Been sold for $6.5 million to an anonymous trust that is said to be this couple, Armie and Elizabeth Hammer. It's secured behind gates, so it's very private. It's fox-timbered English two-door, measures at about 6,300 square feet. Now, it's an updated 1920s residence, so a lot of character in this place. It's absolutely stunning, but modest compared to those mansions that we saw just before.
And needs darker floors, doesn't it?
Well, I like them, but look, the rich timber there. It's good to hear the age of the property because you start to notice the details, the arches in the entry points, the beautiful ceilings. They've got sort of corbelled framing, and look at that bathroom. That's really almost a quite deco in its styling.
It's a bit quirky, isn't it?
Yeah.
So it has that original architecture, double height entry. It has a double sided fireplace that adjoins the living room, shared with an office and a library.
How nice is that green, beautiful tile.
Yeah, stunning. Adjoining a sunroom style family room as well. Very open. It does have its own service quarters as well. Large and slightly outdated high end kitchen arranged around a large work island in this place. A little outdoor area. Unfortunately, it's not that extensive, but it does have what you need. Yeah. Lagoon style swimming pool and spa. It has flagstone terracing and, of course, it's very
looks different on the outside. A little bit more Tudor, mock Tudor, that style. Really high pitched. But, beautiful, very grand home.
Very grand home. Four bedroom and 5.5 bathrooms. So it's a really beautiful traditional place that they've slid into.
Look at that. That's beautiful.
Not expected to stay too long, this couple, because they are on the rise in Hollywood.
Yeah, definitely.
So I think they'll bump up to maybe one of Ellen's.
Was it all about the boy or about the boy? Remember, he was in that beautiful movie. They both got Oscars or they were nominated. He's really good, really great actor.
I'd have met on set then.
Yeah,
it's a love story.
Well, beautiful. Thank you so much. Nice to see you.
Thank you, guys.
Looking through the beautiful properties around the world for us.
Anytime.
No problem.
We'll take you up on that. Thank you, Nicolina.